father and fellow parents are very, very brief. Two issues. One is on discipline, and another is on equality. Now, I'm very glad that Mr. Master mentioned it in his opening remarks that I must speak, and therefore speak and read. And secondly, I want to thank the chairperson of Makoba, who mentioned that discipline does not only relate to students, it relates to we, the parents, and indeed to you, the teachers, and the administration. Mr. Chairman and fellow parents, on the 21st of last month, we woke up to disturbing news. The headline was "Smart Suspects Bobi Wine's Son Over Drug Abuse Confirms Headmaster." Now, this was in Nile Post, it was in Galaxy News, it was in Spire News, it was given in Daily Monitor. And they were quoting you, Mr. Headmaster, having given an interview to the extent that my son was caught with drugs in his school. As a parent, it was very depressing. And I believe to fellow parents, it was very disturbing. I thought, much as I have access to the media, I thought the moral thing to do was to raise this issue on this platform, because this is the ideal platform to raise this. I will mention that for all the years my child has been a student here, I have never attended or even addressed the AGM, because I was always politely requested not to attend in order not to cause what they call unnecessary attention. I thought it important because, like every other parent, I love my child and I want to protect my child, even protect him from himself. Mr. Headmaster and fellow parents, to take us a little back, allow me to lay these facts bare. That young man had been reporting to me a pattern of segregation and targeting on him. As we all parents know, sometimes children lie. So I did not give the young man attention. We raised our children to be leaders. And so my young man always hoped to stand for an elected position in his school. But this one day when he came back home crying for the holiday and told me that he could not run for an elected prefectorial post in his school because the headmaster had blocked him for running for an election, it was disturbing. Now, when all this issue came up, I have spoken to my son. Somehow, and informed me that as the pattern has been going on, this time he had been set up and drugs had been put in his unlocked suitcase and under his bed. I did not believe it at first. Not that I believe it now, but because I want answers and I believe all other parents I want answers. So I was summoned for a meeting with the headmaster and the team from the school. We sat. I took this opportunity to raise all these matters to you, Mr. Headmaster. Of course, I requested that this interview be made in the headmaster's office. I'm only raising this because it was apparently brought to the media by the headmaster. I brought the matter of my son being blocked against running, and these are the reasons I was given, and I want to quote you, Mr. Headmaster. The first reason, Mr. Headmaster, told me that for a child to be a leader in this school, a child must be an A student, not an average student like my son. That was you, Mr. Headmaster. The second reason I was given for my son not running for leadership in this school is that students that are overly popular are not allowed to run for office in this school because they will pose an unfair advantage to their contemporaries. Now, that was disturbing. However, that was not the reason why I had come for that meeting. The reason why I had come for that meeting is because I had been informed by your side master that my child had been found with drugs in the school. And yes, I mentioned it to you, Mr. Headmaster, that when I asked the young man and those around me, he informed me that he would be ready to take all the responsibility and repercussion. But he mentioned one important thing. He told me that the dormitory is filled with CCTV cameras all over. So he challenged the disciplinary committee, Mr. Headmaster, that if they provide the footage of that CCTV camera, he was ready to take every kind of punishment. Incidentally, when the school administration checked, The camera had been cut the day before. Mr. Master, I raised that to you, and I said the same thing, but you told me cameras, every time, they go faulty. So on that day, they were faulty. This is a small camera, Mr. Master. It was very disturbing at the parliament. This is tough because I am very respectful of this school. This school has a unique opportunity to study in our technical study with the comfort of the state of mind. So, we discussed, we went into an understanding. Mr. Master, it was your submission in that meeting on the 31st of January this year that, yes, you did not have any power to expel into the government. In my presence, in the presence of my wife, and in the presence of one of the school lawyers and yourself and the deputy master, that indeed you did not have any fact that boy was not being set up. However, you requested us to understand and agree on a middle ground. You requested us to agree with the suspension because apparently there were other children that were called caught with some crime and were being suspended. So if my son was not being suspended, it would seem and as if there is double standards. So you requested us to agree to a suspension even when there was no power part. I insisted, but my wife convinced me. In effect, the young man was neither guilty nor innocent, according to you. He was there in between. We agreed to that for the good of the school and for the good of the matter not going out there. It felt very unfair, Mr. Master, but because I respect the school and I love it and my son is in love with the school, I agreed to that. It was therefore very unfortunate to see that after those 2 weeks, even when that young man was innocent for as far as evidence is concerned, it was quoted that the headmaster was marked, gave an interview confirming that my son was found with drugs. That was damaging to the future of my son. It was damaging to my personality. It was damaging to my family. If the school, like Mark, cannot investigate such a grave crime like drugs in the school, how do you confirm to us that you are able to investigate something more serious? What if a fire catches this school? How are you going to explain to us as families? Number two, if a young man can be hounded and taunted by a headmaster because there are reports of constant taunting from the headmaster on assembly, in chapel, and personally, and a few teachers and parents can attest to that. I will also mention that some teachers were apparently expelled for being close to young man, that young man. I am informed that my son is psychologically tortured because many of the teachers fear to be seen near him for fear of the wrath of the headmaster. So, my question to the headmaster and fellow parents is, where is a parent supposed to raise these matters? We agree with you, Mr. Headmaster, not to raise these matters in the media because it would be immoral of us. I brought my son here because this is a church-based school. I am a Catholic. Like I mentioned, my grandfather and my father was here, and my brother and my son is here. We want answers. Answers on my behalf and answers to the many disturbed parents that saw this. And if so, it will be all the more to get an apology from you, Mr. Headmaster. Thank you.